All right, guys. So we're back for another one. We're going to show you the bright nickel plating solution onto this copper round that I've scored with the score pad. And we're going to hang it up and see how bright and shiny it will get. We're going to start out by electroplating first thing. And our voltage is way too low, so we're going to go up to 7. I always do 7 volts at least with electro cleaning. 7.5, anywhere in 7 to 8 is good. Gets nice bubbling going on there. Since it's copper and it's freshly scoured, we won't have to leave it in there for very long. Electro cleaner attacks pretty vigorously on this stuff. Okay, so that should be plenty of electric cleaning. With nickel plating, though, the cleaning is really important. If you're doing like an older piece, you would definitely want to electric clean a long time. Okay, we're going to activate now. Same voltage. And with copper, again, it's pretty reactive because this is an acid. So we don't want to leave it in the activator for too long, just maybe 10 seconds at about 6 to 7 volts. And you probably can't tell from the video, but it really kind of changed the luster a little bit. The acid kind of etched it, if you will. And I'm going to turn the voltage down on the nickel. With nickel, the range is 2 to 4 volts, and that really will just depend on what the item is. So I'm gonna start at 3.5 and plop it in and see where it's at. I'm gonna probably shoot for 2.5 while plating. Now the bright nickel has a leveling effect, meaning it's kind of like the bright copper in that, if you've seen that video, if you haven't, go check it out. That bright copper really brightened a piece, similar piece up a lot. And we're gonna see how the nickel compares, but it has a leveling effect that if you were to bright copper plate it first and then bright nickel plate it, a piece like this, if you left it in those two solutions long enough, you would get a mirror finish. I mean, it'll really bring pieces to a mirror finish. And that's what's underneath any car emblem that's chrome plated, is actually got a bright nickel underneath it. And that's where it gets that mirror finish luster that's really hard to ever achieve. So we're just gonna take a peep at it real quick. It's not gonna be bright and shiny yet. Obviously, it's been in there just for a minute. But you know, it's already nickel plated and it's getting there even more. So what I'm gonna do is actually get back with you. We're just gonna leave it in there for, we'll check on it in 5 minutes and then we'll be back. All right, so while that's plating, I thought I'd take this chance to show you how I got that finish before it started. Here's this nasty copper round, one side it's shiny from our copper plating video, but it just got some chemicals on it and got all corroded. These are called Scotch-Brite pads, and each one of these has a different grit, if you will. This one will give it the deepest, biggest scratches, medium, and light. And when you see a brushed finish on something, it's typically done in a similar way, but it's also a good way, and I think this will get this corrosion off of here. I haven't actually tried this exact application of it. And if you go all the same direction like this, it makes it so all the scratches are the same direction. Let me try and show you on here. See? So, and then like this side, it's all shiny but ugly. Let's do this one. And there you go. See, and you could do it cross-directional, and then it gets those scratches in there like that. Anyway, I just wanted to show you that. Let's swing up here and take a look at this nickel. Let's see how it's coming. It's been about 4 or 5 minutes at this point, and I'm willing to bet it's getting shinier. Definitely. You guys are getting a lot of reflection there because it's actually getting quite shiny. And let's play around a little more and see how it gets in another 5, 10 minutes. All right, so It's been about 15 minutes by now. We're just going to check it out, show you what we got. We could keep going. You could nickel plate for hours, but this should get you the point. Let me dry it off real fast here. So although the scratches remain, it is extremely shiny now. You can see your reflection in it. I bet if you left it in there long enough, those scratches would eventually go away. They're probably not deep enough. But anyway, I want to talk a little bit more. So the back didn't get as shiny. It shined up. So if you were going to leave it in there for a prolonged period, you'd want to do half facing one way and then half facing the other. And okay, I want to talk about this setup real quick. So this is the bright nickel. It has to be about 130 to 120 to 140 degrees. This is our air agitation kit, and it just agitates the solution, keeps it moving. You don't want your solution just sitting there still with the nickel plating solution. This is the Joel Master Pro Series HD with electro cleaner with a stainless steel anode. Then you have activator, stainless steel anode, and then the bright nickel has a bag nickel anode. The bag is really necessary, and you must have a nickel anode. All right, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed seeing how the bright nickel works, and thanks for watching.